So this is a bit of a look behind the scenes. I was working on my Pentarotor XL and had a time-lapse camera going, and I'll try to narrate and explain what I happen to be doing. Here I'm just cleaning up a little bit, and here I need to make some new pieces because I actually just screwed up making the template holder frame. So I needed to cut new raw stock and just checking a bunch of stuff here. Filming a little bit about attaching a table and cutting the corners off of there. Which again, I'm filming, so on the bottom there's some corners for letting the dust out. Now, back looking at the plans, and here I'm explaining on video how I'm gonna make the joints for the template holder frame. Now, I've got the occasional fade to black in here, and that's because my camera's actually motion activated, and when I left the shop, it stopped recording, and I just made my video processing script so it fades to black while I'm out of the shop. Here I'm making the spacer blocks for cutting the box joints for the template holder frame, and these need to be done very precisely. I'm actually using my dial indicator to check the fence a little bit. You can see it occasionally lying there on the right. I had it to the right of the fence, so you can't really see it while I'm using it. Now here comes the really cool bit, which is using a series of spacers to cut box joints. I'm not going to explain it in detail because the video I shot explains it plenty well enough already, but you can see here cutting a whole lot of slots just by putting spacers in to make the joints for the template holder frame. And there's quite a lot of repetitive work making all these joints, which in the video normally I don't show, but in a time lapse it's not so bad. Although realistically, it's actually not that much time. If you look on the bottom right of the frame, you can see the time of day, so the minutes are not ticking down that quickly. And here's fixing another screw-up. When I cut the fingers in the mating pieces, I forgot to offset by half a finger's worth, and so there's no way to align these, so I'm grabbing a few more bits of 2x4 to make new pieces to start these joints over again, or at least half of them. Now here's checking the fit, and it turns out the fingers are too fat, so I'm using the same procedure to shave a little bit off the side of each finger. And by now everything fits, and here I stick the template frame together, and now just grab the camera and film assembling it again. Before gluing the template holder frame together, I have to cut a few more notches out of some of the pieces, and I'm doing that on the bandsaw and some of the cuts on the table saw and then back to the bandsaw, and again filming that, of course. I also need to cut some slots and parts of the template holder, and I drilled a bunch of holes on the drill press, which it doesn't actually show very much because I was out of view and not triggering the motion sensor on the camera. And now getting ready to route between those holes. I'm not sure if those holes were really necessary. So I'm just setting up the router. I haven't actually used the router with a fence like that before, at least not this one. Put the dust collector hose on there and then clamp that on the table saw and get the camera ready, of course, and then route and lots of back and forth. I have to route the slots from both sides because I can't route deep enough. Now back to the drill press to drill some mounting hole in some of the pieces right there, and I need those because I can't get in there with the drill afterwards once it's assembled. And now I'm finally getting ready to glue this together, so out comes the camera again and gluing the joints. And now gluing the last two joints with the workpiece lying flat on the table. And once that's done, take a few more pictures of it and just clean it up. And also clean up a little bit in the rest of the shop using the hose from my dust collector just to suck up all the shavings and remove some of the clutter. And here I brought in a piece of birch plywood, which I'm cutting to size and cutting square. That'll make the tabletop. But I'm just cleaning up a little bit here and I'm calling it a day. And now it's the next day, and I need to glue an extra piece of wood on top of the template holder frame to make that a bit thicker. And of course, I'm making video of that. And next, I'm getting ready to mount the table, or the at least the legs, so to say, of the table. Drilling all the mounting holes for that, and that's not very exciting. So I didn't actually have the camera running; it's just sitting there. Next, I need to drill the holes in the tabletop, and just checking it, I realized I cut it just a tiny bit too large, so reducing it a bit and then marking the whole layout of it while I'm recording video of it for all the holes in there. I didn't use the templates because it's just a grid of holes, which I then drill on the drill press right there. And then chamfering the edges with the drill and then the actual holes for mounting it onto the table. And should be getting ready to put it on right there. I'm not sure what I'm doing here. Oh yeah, I missed a few holes, so drilling those ones out. Rounded the corners around the bandsaw, chamfered the edges, and now I'm getting ready to put it on there. So video camera going and screw it on, done. Now back with the template holder frame, and I realized I had some slight unevenness, so I fixed that up with a hand plane, and now chamfering all the edges on it, and getting ready to screw that on and filming it. And checking things over, I realized the table should probably be a bit lower, that would be better. So taking that off and just trimming a little bit off of it with the table saw. Of course, I'll make an adjustment in the plans to have the dimensions that I actually ended up with. Here's some checking things over, and I'm getting one of my templates for cutting a multiple tenon joints, and now carrying it to the back of the shop just because I don't like to have shavings near the workbench. And with the template on there, just preparing to cut my first multiple tenon joint on that thing, and here's cutting it, taking it off, and now what am I doing here? I think I may film another one, just cleaning up the dust right now. The dust really sticks to that raw wood, so I need to varnish that. Then I realized I really need a little clamp to hold the faller on there. So here I'm making that on the drill press and some of my other tools, but you can't see everything because it's aimed at the drill press. Filming that, of course, so that I can then get ready to cut a joint again. And here's cleaning up a bit, and I think I'm getting ready to film it again. Yeah, got the lights here. Here's the camera. Template in. Messing around with it a little bit more, showing how I put the thing on there. Now put the stock on it and get the camera ready and start filming. Now I should cut part of it and then move the camera and cut the rest of it just to change the point of view. Now I switch to my multiple mortise template, which is mounted vertically, so a different orientation. And trying to figure out, changing the bits and figuring out how that's going to align. Clamping some stock onto the table and camera from different angles as I'm filming it. And there's the thing cut, and the fit is not perfect, so I'm trying to figure out what's going on here. It turns out I have some slight inaccuracy in my pantograph that I still need to work out. What I ended up doing is actually cutting these with a little bit of slack so they would still fit into each other just for the video, because I didn't really want to investigate that right now. So here I'm cleaning up a little bit, just sucking up some of the dust and switching back to the multiple tenon template and cutting another joint with a bit more slack. Here's filming cutting it again. And take that one out, and now just showing how it fits together, which is the final scene of that video, and now I'm just cleaning up a bit. I'm doing a little bit of checking of the alignment of things. There's something a bit puzzling about it, but I don't want to fully investigate that right now. Of course, after all that shooting, I need to edit the video, and I've got a huge number of clips here, which I all import into Sony Vegas, and I've got quite a bit of editing that I've done to this. Because to make the video seem all nice and logical and flowing nicely, you actually have to cut out a lot of stuff, because there's a lot of stuff that's pretty boring, as you can see from the time lapse. So that's how I make my videos. The process is pretty long and tedious and not nearly as interesting as the videos themselves, so I probably won't be making that many behind the scenes videos.